particular gadget is going to give Apple a boost. What if I told you it could give this guy an even bigger boost? The new iPhone 5 announced today is forecast to bring in some big bucks at a minimum of 200 smackers a pop and likely 10 million sold this quarter alone. That could be enough to bring this economy a big boost as well. To roll call Shira Tuplitz, who says that Apple's strong sales could actually help the president. It does make sense. I mean, if you argue that it could add up to a third of a percent to GDP, I mean, he's the beneficiary of that, huh?
Right. And anything that has to do with the economy improving, that is good for the president, hands down. Whether it's the unemployment rate decreasing or the number of jobs added every month or something like this, the GDP expanding or the iPhone sales, iPhone 5 sales, I should say, it's good for the president to see economic growth.
You know what scares me about this? I didn't think I would see the day as an economic journalist where our hopes hinged on a phone, our turnaround hinged on a damn phone. Nice phone. It's a phone.
It is a nice phone. It is a good phone. And it's not even a new phone. It's the
right
fifth version of a phone that we've had around for years. And it does say something about the sorry state of our economy, that this is a phone and we're not relying on it, but we're projecting that it could have a massive impact on the U.S. economy. It really does say something about the current state of our economy as well.
And it says a lot to me about where these phones are made. I know Steve Jobs is an icon nearly a year after his death, as he should be. But when he's hailed as he was at the Democratic convention last week, mm-hmm. people leave out the little detail that a lot of these phones are made in China. And it doesn't look good in that respect. But I guess momentum is momentum. Whatever the wind at your back is, you take it, right?
Yeah, and although that is true, a lot of these parts are made in China for the phones, but it doesn't matter because Apple, to most voters and to most American citizens, is a symbol of innovation. The very brand says something about American businesses, whether or not the parts are made abroad or not. I think most Americans view Apple and Steve Jobs as a symbol of the American success story, and that's why you saw both Democrats and Republicans bring up his name and the Apple brand on the podium at their respective conventions over the last 2 weeks.
Amazing. All right. Thank you, Shira. Always good having you.